You know, this is why eBay exists. Hey YouTube, Rob Chesapeake Picker here. Welcome to my channel. So I did not get to do any real sourcing this weekend because the garage sale sucked. I talked about that in my last video, if you watched that one. But I just got back from a major deal. I spent up on this, but I found this on Craigslist. Many of you know, probably all of you know, the Redskins' name is being retired. Right now they're known as the Washington Football Team. Who knows what they're going to come up with. Hopefully it's better than that and not something stupid like the Washington Monuments, because, you know, I'm a Cleveland fan, but all of our Washington teams' names suck. The Capitals, the Senators, the Nationals, they're all stupid. In my opinion, they're all stupid. I get it. You know, we're by Washington, D.C., we got politics, all that, but come on, be a little bit more creative. So we'll see what they come up with. It'll probably be something stupid. But hey, my team's named the Browns, so whatever. We're named after a color. I know we're named after the former manager and all that stuff, but still, doesn't matter. Coach Brown, that's fine. But it's still a color. So I bought a ton of Redskins memorabilia. This guy came across this stuff. He had a friend that died who was a lifelong collector. And you can see my car. This is a Chevy Traverse. It is a 7-passenger vehicle. And my entire back area is filled with merchandise. I probably have, I don't know, 100 jerseys. I have a helmet. I got football that is signed by an entire team. I got dozens of old team calendars. I got cards and plaques, statues, bobbleheads, all that stuff. I spent $500 on all this stuff. If you've been watching my channel, and I still got more coming up in some What's Old videos, Redskins merch has been selling hot. It's going to continue to do so for a while, so these are definite bolos, and I'm going to get these up on the market as fast as I can. You know, this is why eBay exists, and why it does so well. eBay is great for stuff that you can't find anymore. That's why vintage things, old collectibles and stuff like that do so well. And you know what's not in stores anymore? Redskins merchandise. You can't find it anywhere. All the stores have pulled it. It does not exist. It's like it never happened. But guess where you can still find that stuff? eBay and other sites like it. So whether or not you like the Redskins name, I totally get why it changed. I'm all for it. But I also am for making a profit, and I can make a profit on this stuff, and I'm going to. I'm going to track this sale. I'll keep you guys updated on how we do. Hey guys, Rob Chesapeake Picker here. So I had every intention of showing you guys a unboxing video from all of that Redskins gear that I got, but the house was just a madhouse that day with the kids just all over the place, and there just was no good time, and I needed to get through it. So sorry about that. I promise once the shed's here, you're gonna start to see a lot more of that stuff in my upcoming videos. So I did two major bulk buys. So the first one was the Redskins stuff, which you saw in the back of the car. And then the next one was the big lot of cars that I bought. You saw all of those NASCAR things and stuff that I talked about. So between those two things, I spent $1,200 in about 2 weeks. Now, I on average usually spend about $200 to $400 every couple weeks at garage sales, thrift stores, and stuff like that. So I kind of took a couple weeks off on thrifting and garage saling. My last garage sale, which I talked about that weekend, was a bust. And then I just got back from Mancation. So it was the 14th annual trip with my boys. We went out to Kentucky, just rented a cabin and hung out and chilled and relaxed and got away from all of this craziness in the world for a couple days. You can't get much more isolated than nowhere Kentucky. So it was a good time. I'm gonna start rapid firing some videos out here because I did have a lot of things that sold. So let's go ahead and take a look at a few. All right, first thing I got up here is this lot of HO scale train stuff. This is part of that big train purchase that I made. These went out for $15 plus shipping. One of the last trips to the thrift store before I stopped going for a few days, I got this entire box of Cabbage Patch stuff for like $50. It ended up being a 25% off day, so I got a pretty good deal on that. That and everything else I picked up ended up being only $50. I sold this pair of shoes, little Cabbage Patch Shoes for $9.50 plus shipping. These things are super light. They went out in like a 4x4x4 box or a 6x4x4 box. I forget which. So they didn't cost much, maybe about 3 ounce shipping rate. So nice little profit on those. Got another set of Train stuff. Here's just another HO scale tracks. These went out for $10 plus shipping. So far, the HO scale stuff has went out a lot faster than the Lionel trains. I have not really sold any of the Lionel tracks yet. So my pricing and stuff is good with the comps and that, but the HO trains seems to move a little bit better, at least for me so far. Another pack of these stamp hinges. If you haven't seen in my video, I picked up 75 of these things. They go out for $19.95 plus shipping. I got two of these mugs, this Colonial Manor. This is something local to Virginia. I got two of these. I think they were a buck a piece at a thrift store. The first one sold for $8.99 plus shipping. I thought about lotting them up, but the only sold comp I saw did sell individually, and I figure I'd probably get a little bit better deal selling them individually than lotting them up. And plus, there's much less chance for breakage. Anytime you're putting more than one glassware into a box, you know, you do have that opportunity that things are gonna bump and clang together and break. It's a lot easier to secure one item. Not that I don't sell things in larger lots. A lot of those beer glasses and stuff that I put up, I do have in larger lots. But for this one, that's how I chose to set it out. This Grandpa's Potting Shed Jigsaw Puzzle. Picked this thing up cheap at a thrift store. I did have it up a little bit higher during the first shutdown of the COVID situation, but I got in a little bit late on the puzzle game, so I did lower the price down. It sold for $16.75 plus shipping. Got this PS3 game, Sengoku Mesu. I have no idea. My buddy Chris, who I'm selling this stuff for, is into those Samurai Warrior games. This is one of those things. This one sold for $18.99 with free shipping. This is a pretty desirable game as far as PS3 games go. This is my last large lot of those glassine stamp envelopes or coin envelopes or whatever these things are for. I got a whole bunch of these at that train sale. This one sold for $49. With free shipping, it costs about $7 to $9 to ship these out. I have made hundreds of dollars on these envelopes. All the ones that I have left, I had to split up into smaller packages that were about 50 to 100 because the whole box was not in great condition or I didn't have a full set of box. So the big ones are gone, but we've done very, very well on these. Got another wrestler going out. This is Rob Van Dam. I picked this up in a whole big tub of wrestlers. If you've seen these videos, you've seen me ship these guys out. This one was for $11.99 with free shipping, and it costs about $3.25 to ship these guys out. I just bubble wrap them, throw them in an 8x6x4 box, real simple to go. Another video game, Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. With these mass-produced, highly bought video games, these are not great sellers after they've been around for a while, but it still went out. This was for $6.75 with free shipping. A consignment deal, don't tend to make a lot on this one here, but again, I didn't pay for this, so it's $1.50 or whatever it is after the split, the fees that I get to put in my pocket, and it really only cost me a bubble wrap envelope, which is about 20 cents a piece. Not too bad. I don't mind listing this stuff consignment because video games are easy to list, easy to ship, and they sell. This Boston Celtics hat, I got this for probably $2 to $4 at a thrift store. It went out for $25, and that was with free shipping. Hats are real easy to go. With a hat like that, with a wider brim, really good condition. They tend to go out in a 7x7x7 box. Some hats that are a little bit more bent up, you can fit into an 8x6x4, but you don't want to compromise the integrity of the hat because a lot of people, they're buying it for the condition of the hat. So you want to make sure you do keep it in good shape to ship out. 7x7x7, very good box for hats. One more hat going out. This is a Deutschland Germany hat. I picked this up at a garage sale for $1 and it sold for $13 free shipping. And this one went overseas. So when you ship stuff overseas through the global shipping program, you just pay to ship it to Kentucky. I'm in Virginia. It's very close, very cheap to ship that out. And then the last thing we got going out, this was from my big bust of a weekend at garage sales where I didn't even have anything worth showing you guys. But I did pick up this DVD set of the show The Prisoner. I got all of these for $5 and they sold for $45. plus shipping. They go out media mail. It's very cheap, costs around $4 to the buyer to ship those out, and it was a nice quick mover. So DVD box sets, if you can get them for a good price, always a good bet, especially on rare stuff like this. All right, guys, that is all I got for today. Thanks for checking out the show. Please remember to hit that like button and subscribe. Drop me a comment down below, and I will see you guys on the next one.